Tonight's scripture reading is Romans chapter 12, verse 19 to 21. Never take your own revenge, beloved one, but leave room for the wrath of God, for it is written, Vengeance is mine, I will repay, says the Lord. But if your enemy is hungry, feed him, and if he is thirsty, give him a drink, for in so doing you will heap burning coals on his head. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. Amen.
I
hope many will give testimonies. We have Pastor Sujin Lee is beside me. She will deliver a message under the title of Keep Your Feelings Under Control. Let's welcome her with hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We give all thanks and glory to Father God, who will manifest His power for us. Emmanuel Choir and this orchestra, thank you for the praise. And GCN, thank you for Manmin Magazine. Father God, you know, wants to make you healthier, and He wants to solve your problems so that those who are healed would love Father God all the more and work more faithfully and more vigorously, right? Father God wants them to do like so. Because, you know, Father God healed us first, but when we became faithful, Father God gave us more blessing. So those who testify to their healings, they are talking about the same. They are better. The one who testified to his healing, he said he is healthier about like 10 years, by 10 years by others, and then others. But, he, moved his heart so that, he could control his, mind. And I remember that he used to be absent for long, but once he came back to Father, when he was in difficulties, he realized why he was having those difficulties, but he received healings and answers to his prayers. So I hope you can, think of what you have done wrong before Father God and repent of it. Then you will solve all your problems. Father God will heal you. And once Father God heals you, when you have another problem or the same problem again, then there must be something wrong in you. Then you got to realize it, find it, repent of it, and Father God will make you healthier, and Father God will give you more answers to you. Father God is such a good God. So tonight, I hope every one of you can receive this grace, not only those who are sick, but also those who want to receive answers, who want to solve their problems. I hope you can receive these answers and healing works. Say, I think I have something to repent of. Or if you have something bothering your mind, such as like a losing first love, or not receiving the fullness of the Holy Spirit, if you don't have them, then find something that you have to repent of. And you may receive the grace to repent of. I hope tonight will be such a night of God's grace. So that, you can make yourself the one who are healed or the one who receives answers. For all this week, what did you see? The novel coronavirus. The whole world is afraid of that disease now. And we already knew this, and we prayed for it. So by the prayer of Senior Pastor and by the power of our shepherd, all those new diseases can be healed. By the power of our shepherd, Father God will let the whole world know about this, you know, power. So the heads of many countries, you know, asked for this prayer. So we experienced many people in many countries were healed of those diseases. We experienced it. The novel coronavirus is, you know, spreading more quickly than ever. Are you afraid? No, you are not, huh?
Thank you.
Since you have the handkerchief the senior pastor prayed on, you don't need to be afraid of. If you're coughing, well, I believe, you know, I heard the same. This is the time when the coronavirus is spreading. I'm so thankful that we have this divine healing meeting. When I heard it, I was and I became so proud of you. So I'm going to pray for you and for this virus. But through the senior pastor's prayer for the sick, we've been protected all the time. And by any chance, if you're coughing or if you have some, you know, body temperature going up, and there is the senior pastor's prayer for the sick, and you have this handkerchief the senior pastor prayed on. So don't be afraid. You know, this kind of epidemic diseases or newly discovered diseases like a coronavirus, well, the medical science are well advanced and so many technology, but the people cannot create a vaccine for this newly discovered virus. Well, Father God doesn't regard it so hard. I mean, it is so easy for God. So many good readers and district leaders, they visited many people and then consoled their hearts and they prayed for them so that they could receive the healing works. I hope you can continue to do so, so that those who left this church could come back. This message has the title of Keeping Your Feelings Under Control. Actually, this message was delivered by senior pastor in 1994 during two-week special revival meeting. The messages during the two-week special revival meetings are actually telling you the secrets and shortcuts to receive blessings and answers and healing works. And those messages contain a solutions to our problems. So today's message is the same. If you have a problem, aren't you be healed? Do you have any answer? Do you have any prayer titles that you don't receive answer yet? Answers and healing works and blessings. To receive them, you should not have any wall of sin before Father God. You gotta discover them and find them and get rid of it. And one of the big reasons to have that kind of wall of sin is because of your ill feelings. That's what I'm going to tell you. So through this message, I would like to tell you what kind of, effect these small, such as little ill feelings have in your life. So there will be a feelings of joy, feelings of love, and at the same time, there is a feelings of anger and some feelings of sorrow and hatred. But this message is about controlling your ill feelings, such as evil feelings and feelings based from the untruth. When you have these ill feelings, you may get angry. You may burst into anger for something trivial, and you don't have good relationship with others. Furthermore, you hated them and you make them your enemies. Since you cannot control your ill feelings, you ruin your projects or the disputes and arguments arouse between you and your family and among your friends. There are many problems occurred because of this. When you reveal your ill feelings out, some people commit murder. We heard this quite a lot because of some noise between floors in the residence under the floor couldn't sleep well because of noise from the upstairs and in the residence in the upstairs were angry about that, and then they fought each other, and then they killed people. You heard this news. And what about, you know, last happy new Lunar Year? The parents and the scolded children. The children didn't like that. And because of some ill feelings piled up so far, he couldn't control it. You know, he committed suicide after the Lunar New Year holidays. And during the you can hear so many, you know, great arguments that happened in during the holiday season, right? Why? Because, you know, they suppressed their ill feelings, and those ill feelings, you know, came out, and that, you know, developed into arguments and disputes, and peace is broken among the family. Small and trivial ill feelings and pile upon, and then some people, you know, have ill feelings against his friends who did bad things to him. And then, so, controlling your feelings is necessary to enjoy peaceful life, especially if you are holy children of God. And you shouldn't have any ill feelings that are based from evil and untruth. These ill feelings will eventually become a wall of sin before Father God, so that you cannot receive answers and blessings from Father God. Say, you have ill feelings against your family member, your neighbor, your friends, your siblings, or if you, you know, have the ill feeling inside your heart, you didn't reveal it. But actually, that becomes a wall of sin before Father God. You got to remember this. Well, I just have this feeling against my friend or my, you know, neighbor. I don't have any ill feelings against my God. You cannot say that. Those ill feelings, evil feelings against your friend, against your neighbor, Father God already told you never do that. Since you did that, it became sin. You got, you know, those, you know, ill feelings against your family member or friend or neighbor. Since that became a wall of sin before Father God, it blocks you from receiving answers and blessings. So you got to change. Matthew 5, verse 22 to 24, the Lord said, "But I say to you that everyone who is angry with his brother shall be guilty before the court. And whoever says to his brother, 'You good for nothing,' shall be guilty before the Supreme Court. And whoever says, 'You fool,' shall be guilty enough to go into the fiery hell." Therefore, if you are presenting, not because, you know, he said this to Father God, but he said this to his, you know, friend, he goes to fiery hell. So now verse 23. Therefore, if you are presenting your offering at the altar, and then remember that your brothers have something against you, leave your offering there before the altar and go. First, be reconciled to your brother, and then come and present your offering. If you get angry, if you swear, or for you, if you ignore others, these are the deeds and words based on evil feelings. But the Lord says that you are going to have the some difficulties because of that after you did this evil. So, when you have some of the deeds of the body and then deeds of the flesh, based on, you know, what Lord said in Matthew 5, 22 to 24, when you have like a hatred and jealousy and envy, not only that, but if you don't get rid of it, you cannot go to, you know, good heaven. As written in Matthew, you have ill feelings in your heart, but you didn't reveal. When you reveal it outside, it becomes even gravier sin that you might expect. Okay? So, you revealed your ill feelings toward your friend, and that makes your opponent feel difficult. But it becomes your own difficulty. That big difficulties, you may not Experience it now. After you did something to your friend, let's say you get angry at your friend, you hurt your friend. You think you just hurt your friend, and this ill feeling. I mean, some people feel easy after they, you know, reveal their ill feeling or anger. And they feel some they gotta have some ease, peace of mind, well, because you know, they got so much evil in their heart. They may feel like that, but later on, all they did become a misfortune to them, and they may receive some hardships and the blocks. I mean, the hindrances because of what they did in the past. Let's say not only just they're having ill feelings, but when they burst that ill feelings into burst into anger, then they don't even realize when, you know, they don't even realize that they did something in the past, and so you know, they don't know how to solve it. So even if you pray, even if you give offerings without being reconciled with your friend, you can receive answers and blessings. Now, you came to altar to give your offering. Now, if you found something that you are not in peace with your friend, then you gotta leave the offering on the altar and go back to your friend and reconcile with your friend and come back and go and then give the offering to God. Then you can receive answer. Without it, you can receive answers and blessings. Something, you know, somebody hate you. I mean, that's not what I'm saying. You hated someone, you get angry at someone, you bothered someone, you hurt someone, but you don't, you know, you ignore them. You feel like, I got no problem. Well, you are so fool. As you did something evil to your friend or your friend or your people around you, you don't realize how greatly what you did affect your life. You don't realize it. Through this message, I hope that you can understand this tonight. And if you repent of it, then you will solve all your problems tonight. After this message, well, I did something to my friend, but and I'll just repent before Father God. Well, you have to go to your friend and repent. And then you got to come back and then repent before Father God as well. And give offerings, okay?
Or
if you make up your mind to repent of what you did to your friend, and then Father God will give you answer once you decide
it. I hope that 하나님과 사이에 죄의 담이 헐어지는 축복의 시간이 되시기를 주님의 이름으로 부탁드립니다. 그리고 이후에는 그런
I hope that through this message that you can realize what kind of ill feelings you have against someone, realize it, and repent of it, and then break down that wall of sin before Father God, and make this moment a moment of blessing, okay? Usually, when you did something to your friend or your family, I mean, if someone does, you know, hurts your family, then you regard them as your enemy. And you want to take the vengeance on it. However, the scripture of tonight tells us leave that unto the hands of Father God. Romans 12, verses 19 to 21 says, never take your own revenge, beloved, but leave room for the wrath of God. For it is written, vengeance is mine, I will repay, says the Lord. Now, someone did something evil to you or to your family or to your friend. So, you regard him as your enemy. But the Father God says, vengeance is mine, I'll repay. Now, verse 20, but if your enemy is hungry, feed him. And if he is thirsty, give him a drink. For in so doing, you will heap burning coals on his head. Worldly people, you know,
혹여 내가 뭐 직접 그 사람을 때릴 수는 없어도 마음 안에 악한 감정을
worldly people you know take you know they're on revenge on those enemies and they don't think it's evil okay they will say it makes sense however people of God even if someone did something to your family or to you
원수 같은 사람이라 할지라도 미워하거나 싫어하지
않고
도리어 어떻게 하라고요?
But rather
give him, feed him,
give him drink.
이렇게 선하게 하라고 말씀하십니다.
Do good to your enemy.
내가 숯불을 그 머리 원수의 머리에
So in doing so, you will heap in the burning coals on his head.
사람의 머리에 숯불을
Let's say if you put in a burning coal on your head, what's going to happen? Your head will burn. And you will get burned. And he will be in a greatly harmed. But Father God tells you, don't do it on your own. When you do goodness to him, Father God, the judge, will do it for you. That's what he says. But don't say, well, if I do goodness, then Father God will take revenge on behalf of me. Don't think about. I'm not saying you should think about this. Don't think of it, but just do goodness so that those people who did evil to you, do goodness to you. And Father God may remember, what you did and the goodness you did. Someone bothered you, someone gave you difficulties, so you think he is your enemy. And even God says, he called him an enemy. But, feed him and give him a drink. Do goodness to him, then Father God will take care of him. That's what he says. Now, do not take your own revenge. That's what Father God says. Why? Let me tell you why. Okay? John 5:27 says, He gave him authority to execute judgment. It means God gave the Lord Jesus Christ authority to execute judgment. And 1 Peter 1:19 says, With precious blood, as of a lamb, unblemished and spotless, the blood of Christ. Because only Jesus Christ, who is sinless, can receive the authority to judge. There is no one who is sinless like Jesus. So, sinner cannot condemn others' sin. So, not a single man have right to judge another man. Matthew 7:5 says, remember this, okay? Take a revenge on someone means you taking a revenge on someone means that you become a judge. Let's say, If you watch movies, worldly people call them righteous. Some people are so evil.
못된 사람인데 그런데 어떤 자기의 권세나 힘을 통해서 피해간단 말이에요. 피해 가서 그의 잘못
Those evil people, avoid, those vengeance, reusing all kinds of legal system. Then there is someone else, who taken revenge on them on behalf of the one who was hurt. And the people call that one, righteous. However, that's not, right, righteous, Father God says. The retribution will be given by Father God to them. He is so evil. Judging him like that is to become a judge, says God. If you want to take revenge on someone, it means you regard yourself as a judge. Now, Matthew 7:5, the Lord said, You hypocrite, first take the log out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to take the speck out of your brother's eye. And Romans 3, verses 10 to 12 says, As it is written, there is none righteous, not even one. There is none who understands. There is none who seeks for God. All have turned aside. Together they have become useless. There is none who does good. There is not even one. But there are so many people who easily judge and condemn and gossip about others. However, in many parts of the Bible, Father God tells us never gossip, never judge, never condemn. Especially, James 4 verses 11 and 12 says, Do not speak against one another, brethren. He who speaks against the brother or judges his brother speaks against the law and judges the law.
라고 거짓말하여서 서로 논하는 것만이 판단이 아니라 상대의 잘못에 대해서 논하는 것을 판단이라고 하시는 거예요. 그것을 심판하는 자가 너가 되어졌다라고 성경은
This is what Father God says, okay?
형제를 판단하는 자는
But if you judge the law, you are not a doer of the law, but a judge of it.
율법을 판단하면
There is only one lawgiver and judge. The one who is able to save and to destroy. But who are you who judge your neighbor? God gave us the law, and we are the doers of the law. However, if we judge and condemn our brothers, we are so arrogant. It is so grave sin because we became a judge. Even the Lord, who received the authority to judge, said he came to the earth not to be served but to serve. He came to the earth and he didn't judge anyone. He just said, I came here to serve, not to be served. Therefore, who truly believe in the Lord should serve each other. Instead of judging and condemning and gossiping others, we will serve each other. Philippians 2:3 says, With humility of mind, regard one another as more important than yourselves. Then we can regard others more important than ourselves. If you regard others more than yourself, then you cannot ignore them. You cannot judge them. You cannot condemn them. You cannot gossip about them. You would rather love them. Therefore, we got to realize and we got to clearly understand that we got no right to judge others. So we should never judge. We should never take the revenge on others. Our Father God is the sole judge. So leave everything unto the hands of Father God and resemble our Lord who completed the law with love. So we have to overcome evil with goodness. So our pastors, when you deliver a message, when someone does evil, then you may pinpoint it is wrongdoing. You shouldn't do this. You teach like that. We cannot say it is a judge. It is to become judge. You teach them to turn back. It is to teach them to repent and turn back. It is not to judge, okay? Why did you do that? If you do that, you knew it is evil. You knew it is evil. You knew it is retribution. That is called judging and condemning. That's what the Bible says. I'm telling you about, it's not, I'm not going to tell you about the judging and condemning, but what Father God tells us is that don't ever judge and condemn and gossip about others. It is grave sin before Father God, and it is great, arrogance before Father God. So we got to remember and use it to reflect upon others, reflect upon ourselves. I'm giving you this message so that you can find something to repent of. Then you might have forgotten. Remember this message and try to reflect yourself upon this message and find something that you have to repent of. And you, if you turn back and Father God will tell you, you are forgiven. Well, as you listen to a message, you may have something you may feel guilty. And if you repent of what you're doing wrong, then you may be refreshed. So all you gotta do is just repent. So Father God tells us about ill feelings. So we should never judge and condemn others, and we cannot become a judge. We got no right to judge for Father God. In your life,
In
When you, you know, judge and you may gossip and you may condemn others, then Father God tells you that, you know, you became a judge. So, in your life, if you did something like that, then you've got to repent completely and turn back. Now, and as we live our lives, you may come across many things and feelings around, right? So what kind of feelings are they? And why? When you have, when do you have that kind of ill feelings?
Well,
I would like to give you some examples because of the time given. So I pray to Father God, please, the Holy Spirit, help us to realize, you know, as we listen to this message. By the help of the Holy Spirit, you may remember the moments that you had ill feelings in your life. And I hope that you can realize it was evil, it was, you know, untruth, and the Father God hates it, it was a grave sin. You may realize it by the help of the Holy Spirit. Okay? I cannot give you all the detailed explanation, but I have to continue this message. So, I'm telling you when you have this kind of ill feelings, okay? First, when things are not in accordance with your thought and heart and standards, you may have ill feelings. You may be bothered in your heart, and you may get angry, and it may develop into arguments and disputes. People grow up in a different environment. They may have different education, so their standards and their thoughts are all different. However, if you try to apply the standards, then there will be always disputes and inner quarrels. We all think our thoughts are right, and your feelings are right. We all think like that. Everybody. However, you gotta admit that your thought and someone else's thought may be different. So who is right then? Those who follow the truth, those who become the children of God, those who want to become a children of spirit and whole spirit, you know, though they should not insist on their own ideas. I am right. My feeling is right. You know, I am better than him, so what I'm feeling is, you know, right. If you don't admit it, you can become a man of spirit, and you can make peace with others. If you think, you think you're right, and it's not easy to yield to others. Because you think, you know, you're right, but others are not right. But you had to break the thought, and you can truly become a good man. And Father God will be pleased with you. So many, you know, uneasy feelings and ill feelings, and you got so many, the peace is broken between someone. Because, you know, he is wrong and you're right. And you think that, why is he, you know, sticking on his own idea? Because he thinks that he is right. That's why he is insisting on his own idea, just like you do. Think of his position. He is exactly doing what you're doing. And you think he is stubborn. And he thinks you're stubborn too. So, you must be able to say, I'm wrong. You should be able to say like that with humility. He may have a reason to say so. So your thought and his thought may be different. Then lower yourself, okay? And try to, you know, make peace with him. Most of ill feelings and uneasy feelings in you, and peace breaking, usually that happens because when you think you're right, but others are not right, then you may control your ill feelings if you control them. So it can happen even between, you know, husbands and wives. They may have, you know, different tastes, different personalities, different etiquettes, different tastes, and different, you know, different ideas. But they, you know, stick to their own idea, and they try to, they want others to listen to them. Well, that's what everybody thinks, right? But they don't do so when in the early phase of, you know, they're in a relationship, they don't do so, but later on, they want the other to listen to you. If you yield little by little, then if you listen to others, then you can make a peace family. However, because of your stubbornness and your, you know, your own idea and self-righteousness, then, you know, you may have ill feelings. You ask your spouse to listen to you. You are stubborn like that. So there is conflict between you. That happens inside the church. Let's say, if you say, I'm right, but you're wrong, then peace is broken. You cannot be united. You may be wrong. Even if you think you are more educated, but to make peace, you may listen to others. That's goodness. That's the truth. That's what should happen in the church. But not only in the church, but also in your family, to your spouse, to your parents, to your siblings, to your neighbors, to your co-workers. If you become like this, then it's so good, right? In your company. Even one sentence of a legal paper. People may have different ideas about that one sentence. So the truth tells us, you are stubborn if you stick to your own idea. Listen to others and yield. Now, we, human beings, we think we are right. Please listen to me. We have this kind of feeling all the time, every one of us, because we love each other. We want others to listen to you. We want to say that we are right to others. You've got to admit that. So, you ask your spouse to listen to you, and you express it, and your spouse does not listen to you, then there is an argument, you raise your voice, and become a quarrel. Now, grown-ups, why do you have quarrels between you and your spouse? And you just ignore your spouse instead of quarreling. You don't admit that you two are different. You think your spouse is, you know, less than you are. So you cannot make peace with your spouse. That's arrogance. And you've got to break that arrogance. That's not right. Your spouse may have different characteristics than yours. Let's say your wife puts something always intact, and but you put your towels everywhere. Now, then you have to listen to your wife, right? But you don't listen to her. Your wife asks you to put things organized all the time. Then you gotta listen to her. You gotta do it. That's love. That's how to make peace. And that's the truth. But you don't do that. You just complain. Man, my wife is always trying to make things organized. Then your wife thinks that, you know, man, he is so, you know, he got so many deficiencies of the body. As I, you know, live with my Mrs. Bonglim Lee, I was with the prayer house, right? Mr. Sujin Lee, don't you feel uncomfortable with me? Then why? I don't. Mrs. Bonglim Lee cares for me and, you know, and takes care of me. And we used to be in the same place for about 3 months in the prayer house, right? So we found some differences between us, like a taste, you know, and after, I mean, the how to wash dishes, you know, there's some things, you know, we were different, right? Then what should we do? We may ask, and then this would be better. And the other listen to you, doesn't listen to you, then you just do the way the other does. So I once said, Mrs. Bonglim Lee, I'm always in the straits. Does it make you uncomfortable? But she said, no. Well, so I don't feel any uncomfortable with you. Because we love each other. In other stuff, you know, we can just serve each other. And Mrs. Bolini serves me all the time. So I serve her all the time. So we make peace with others. We make peace between us. You know, we think in advance what the other wants to eat. Then just we enjoy that. Well, sometimes, you know, from time to time, you know, I listen to you. Now it's time for you to listen to me. If you expect that, then you cannot become united. You just keep on listening. Then you will change eventually, right? If you keep on listening to others, then, well, I hope that the other can listen to me as I you know, made sacrifice. Well, no, that's not true goodness. You are expecting something in return. It's because, you know, you love yourself, then the other cannot change. Without expectation, without something in return, you just listen. You just do what the others want you to do. Then you can be united. And the Holy Spirit should work. And others, the Holy Spirit will make the other's heart change. So parents and children, when you look at each other, someone has less faith. Do you feel uncomfortable? No, you got in the pity of them, and you got to understand their situation. Well, this is what I thought. Well, as I pray for the goodness, I thought about senior pastor and for the Lord. I know the truth. But there are people who know the truth, but they don't practice the truth. I had a time that I couldn't do. Then, you know, as I realized, you know, I got tired and I was kind of, you know, I got tired when I did something wrong that I repent of the other day. So, as I remember those things that I experienced, and I pray for others, then as I did that, you know, I had a peace of mind. Instead of like, why don't they, you know, do this? Why don't they do that? And I'd rather, you know, in a pity for those, you know, who know the truth but who don't practice the truth. And I feel sorry for them. Then, you know, to that extent, you know, I could fill my heart with goodness. Yesterday and today, and a whole year passed. That man didn't change at all. But I prayed for him, and a year passed. Now someone didn't change, but I changed because I prayed for him, because I filled my heart with goodness. I took pity for him. I felt sorry for him, and I prayed for him with goodness. So I am changed this much, and because of this situation, I was changed by the truth, and I came into the Spirit, and Father God is pleased with me. Father, you gotta change yourself like that. Well, he doesn't listen to me, you know. A member of my family doesn't have good faith, and that became pressure on me. So that's why, you know, I was always, you know, frowning on my face. You know, you don't need to say that. That kind of situation gave me a opportunity to make you a better person. Then you could receive blessing for that. So don't make an excuse. Don't put blame on others. Because of that, you know, I got irritated. Because of someone, you know, I got angry. You mean, you know, if you don't have someone, then you would not have that kind of ill feelings. Don't put blame on your environment or people, other people. Because of you, you're evil in your heart. You were irritated in your heart and you got ill feelings. Please get rid of these ill feelings, evil from your heart. A family don't have a conversation at all for many, many days. Now, a wife ask for conversation to reconcile. Then it's time to listen, right? And try to understand each other. That's the moment. For example, your wife, you know, comes up to you and to, you know, to reconcile. Now try, you gotta listen to what you said, and you gotta listen to what others say. This kind of situation, wife and husband didn't have conversation for many, many days. Now, wife, you know, says, you know, I want to talk to you. Then they have to listen to each other, right? Even the one who approaches, in this case wife, should listen to each other. Now, counselor, they say, when someone says something, instead of saying your position, but listen. and not. And when someone says something, then you may have your own idea, right? But you suppress it, don't say it, and you just listen. So it's difficult in the beginning. However, if you keep on pressing that in your own idea, instead of saying something back to her, if you do that, you cannot make trip. You two will go in a parallel, okay? Instead of that, you listen. But if you don't listen, but if you stick to your own idea, then you all say, I came up to you to make it up, but you talk about your situation all the time, and you don't listen to me. Yeah, they don't listen. They cannot make peace. That happens in your church. That happens in your core. At your work. But we gotta remember, when someone. No, it's not because someone opened their hearts. It's because you shut down your heart. You didn't listen. You didn't listen to others. You are so stubborn. You got that evil in your heart. It all started from there. When this repeats, then love cools down. Some people don't live. They live just without love. However, don't try to find problems from others. Ask yourself, how many times did I ill? How many times did I sacrifice? Did I truly serve her or serve him from the depth of my heart? Then your problems can be solved if you can answer this question. Let's say there is another chance to have ill feelings. When you have some loss or when you face some difficulties. Well, you may encounter a chance. Someone is so stubborn. He's just telling you something untrue. Then you may regard him like a child. And just listen. Just listen and pray for him or pray for her. And try not to have any ill feelings in you. Do not judge. Why is he so stubborn like that? Instead of judging him like this, try to understand it. If you do so, then your ill feelings will turn into good feelings. If you have such good feelings, then Father God will regard you good person. Now, what do you want me to give to you? Okay? Another chance. When you have some disadvantage or face some difficulties, for instance, your feet was stepped on, then you got irritated. You made an order, but your dish came out late. Then you got angry, and you raise your voice. You may, you don't feel good. I'm so angry, but why my dish comes so late? If you have that kind of thought before, then, why should I get angry like that? Let's say our male members, you came home late. Your wife didn't fix your table for you quickly. Are you angry? No more? If you're still like that, then you're going to change. Well, that is so childish. For nothing, you got angry. You complained. You used to be like that, as I told you earlier. In case of different ideas, and why did you do that? It was wrong. You knew it was wrong. Why did you do that? You scold him like that. Then you got to realize that you were like a child. You didn't have some grown-up goodness. Your level of goodness is so low. You got to realize this. So, you don't, endure some disadvantage, and you get easily got upset. Now, when you have some disadvantage, like someone, someone bumped into your shoulder, and then you got so easily upset. Before you did that, long time ago you did that. and you reduced it, and you suppressed your ill feelings, and something happened, something you couldn't never understand, then you don't express your anger out, but you have some ill feelings in your heart, but you still keep pressing it. Okay? And you think to yourself, that, why does he do so? In your heart, you hate it. You don't like it. That's the another look of judging and condemning, okay? They're all from the ill feelings from your heart, but they develop into different actions or different deeds in different level. Now you can suppress your ill feelings to some extent, to some degree, but you still have something in your heart, then you got to repent of it and get rid of that wall of sin. But if you repent of it, you can break the sin. Father God, and because of this little thing, I got angry. But I know that I shouldn't be like this. In the past, about a year ago, I used to be like that. So, please forgive me. Then people around you would be embarrassed if you become angry like that. Because of your that little action make people around you embarrassed, and they may feel they don't feel good, and you make their life hard.
나랑 비슷한 모습을 행하고 있는 사람을 좀 이렇게 객관적으로 보세요.
Try to watch someone who are similar to you. What I'm saying is that if you stick to your own idea quite pretty often, then find someone who does the same. Who sticks to his own idea all the time, who points out others' faults, and who does not wait, and who express their ill feelings outside. If you keep watching them, then you may realize that that's not good. That doesn't look good. It is so evil by the standard of the truth. You can watch him and you can realize it. Then you pray for it, and then make that as a chance to change yourself. Then you may realize that it is so evil. When you admit it like that, you can quickly change. You can change yourself quickly, all the more. There are some people who cannot adapt themselves to social life. Some people say, I'm saying what I have to say. They don't control their ill feelings, so they make others trouble. But they don't even realize that people around them are embarrassed. Such things can happen around in the worldly people. Look at the world. There are so many people who sue others. If you go to a district office, they complain. You can find the one. The person is the only one who complains. If he doesn't come to district office, that village or that district office is in peace. Fix that and fix this, and I don't like it. I don't like this in my neighbor. Sometimes it needs money, it needs time, it needs manpower to fix and correct all those things. Because of that one person, entire office workers in the district office can feel difficult. So in your life, in your company, at your work, because of some disadvantage that you may feel, can you press it? Can you endure it? Or you may complain about it. You gotta ask yourself. Goodness is to take disadvantage. When someone does evil to you, you should be able to do good. Why? because you can take this advantage instead of revealing your ill feelings against it. And that's not goodness, the way you must pursue, okay? So you've got to ask yourself what you were before. Now, there are people who even complain against God. Those who don't believe in God complain against the sky or in heaven or God. They get angry at God when they face some typhoons or some disasters. Israelites who escaped from Egypt complain against Moses and God when something was not for them. They said they believed in God, but when they don't receive answers to their prayers, or when they encounter some difficulties, they misunderstood God and they complained against God. There are some Christians like that. It is so evil. They welcome trials and tribulations by themselves. So don't be fooled like that. Especially in this moment of blessing, we should never complain against God. So ask yourself what kind of mind, what kind of feelings you have against God. Someone says like this, well, in my Christian life, as a mommy member, as I encounter these things, I can all the offerings, all the faithfulness, where are they? All the rewards, all the faith, they made it nothing. You gave offerings, where did they go? It went to God. You went to the storehouse in heaven. You prayed for a world mission. You prayed a grand sanctuary. By faith, those prayers. Since you prayed by faith, you're all stored up in heaven. And it will surely happen. So, even if it's not taking place right now, it is all your rewards in heaven. There are people who say, you know, it's not going to happen. And they left the church. And you listen to them? Now you lost your faith if you said that. Please, repent of it. You gotta repent. You met this church. You became healthy. You came to know heaven and New Jerusalem. You felt God. You saw God through miracles, thanks to our senior pastor, who leads us to New Jerusalem. You've never heard such messages that can analyze evil hidden deep inside your heart. And we are being protected in this space of the shepherd. Even though the coronavirus is around, you are not afraid. Why? Because you got faith. Why? Because you experienced it. Such great power of the shepherd. You experienced it. So because of you are not afraid. Now, all the grace and blessing, where are they? You lost them? You forgot them? After you experienced some difficulties? How can you say you are not different from Egyptians who escaped Egypt? How can you say he was not complained? He was complained. I didn't do against the senior pastor. I didn't do against God. Because, you know, some situation is so odd. Because, you know, I was, you know, disturbed by others. Well, you complain against God. If you did that, repent of it. And please have relationship with Father God back. 경우로 이유 없이 원망을 듣거나 피해를 보았을 때가 있습니다. 예를 들어 Another chance of have ill feelings. 오해를 받는 경우이지요. 하지도 않은 나쁜 말과 got some loss without any reason. You didn't do anything, but you were misunderstood. So you got angry. Someone made rumors about you. So you are alienated, and you got some loss. And you don't feel good, and you may complain, and you may argue. Another example. You were pointed, or you were rebuked because someone else's mistake. But that one who made a mistake don't feel sorry for you. Then you hate him. You were pointed by your superior because of something you did wrong, but you were more scolded than you expected. Then you feel don't good. You don't feel good. 억울해하고 서운한 감정. Psalm 37:1 says, "Do not fret because of evil doers. Be not envious toward wrong doers." We have experienced this in the wrong. We may have experienced this. Think about senior pastor. He experienced all these unfair things. And what did he do? He didn't regard anything. He did goodness to everybody. Yeah, you hated someone who bothered you, who gave you troubles, who told you about rumors. Why do you have ill feelings against them? Why do you commit sin because of that? You don't need to. If you don't have evil, you wouldn't do so. However, because of evil feelings arise because of that evil in your heart. You know, once it's revealed, it's rather blessing for you. Then because you can realize that, aha, I had ill feelings. I got such evil in me. That's why I had the ill feelings. Now, someone bothered you, someone gave you troubles, and, you know, some evil feelings, you know, came out. Then you got to hold on to it, repent of it, and pull it out by root. Then you can come into sanctification. If you don't do it, by the way, if you keep on angry at someone, if you, you know, reveal your ill feelings, don't pull it out, then you make an excuse, then, you know, because of this, because of my special situation, I couldn't but angry. And you cannot accomplish goodness, sanctification, and because of evil feelings that became wall before Father God, and you cannot receive answers. So, then you gotta leave things onto the hands of Father God so that He can solve your problems. But you just follow goodness. You may have ill feelings because of others' wrongdoings. Psalm 37:1 says, "Do not fret because of evildoers." This is what Father God says. But you got angry at someone's wrongdoings, right? You do so from time to time. Why? Because do you frequently do it or from time to time? Well, it's because you got no love and forgiveness in your heart. Let's say someone gives you an instruction. Someone speaks in a harsh language. Then you may think to yourself that he breaks peace all the time. You may have ill feelings like that. That's judging and condemning. This is evil. This is hatred. However, if you think about his fervor and, you know, embrace him with goodness, then ill feelings will not arise. And at the same time, you may have strength to change that person instead. Maybe there may be someone who did a great evil. And you got to remember that Father God is the only judge, so you should never be the judge. So, if you see some evildoers, then you got to have in mercy, and you got to pity of him. Then you can be loved by Father God. Now, there are people, I mean, there are chances that, you know, you may have ill feelings when people are doing good. You know, when your cousins become rich, then you may envy, you may become jealous, right? These are because of envy and jealousy. King Saul was the example. You know, he got jealous of, you know, King David, right? So ill feelings, you know, came out, and it developed into a murder, even though he killed, you know, David, and he tried to kill David. Because of time, I have to stop my message. This message is not to judge, not to condemn, not to gossip. Do not fret because of evildoers. Don't have even your enemies. You gotta do good to him. And leave. The wrath is Father God's job. I gave you some examples when you have ill feelings, okay? Those evil feelings arise because you have evil in your heart. If you don't have any evil, such ill feelings cannot develop in your heart. In 2019 and 2018, you may find some evil or ill feelings in your heart? Or did you have goodness and good love? If you do have, if you did have you know, evil feelings and ill feelings, please repent of it. You gotta repent of them and look for goodness, long for goodness. Some people, you know, might you know, come into goodness easily after you know, repenting and turning back. But you gotta truly realize that you were evil. Father, I stick to my own idea. It was evil. I just you know, said you know, they were wrong. You know, I just thought to myself that why does he do so? Because of him, and I thought and I was evil. But it was all because of my evil, you know, hatred and anger and judging and condemning. If you you know find this, and if you repent of it, then Father God will say you are so lovely when you try to repent and turn back. And later on, you gotta hold on to these evil feelings and get rid of them. In your life, there are many chances that you may have ill feelings. When you are tired, when you have difficulties, someone bothers you, someone you know, hits you, someone makes rumors about you. If you don't, if you are not troubled, then it is so good for you. Someone tries to drag you down. Someone tries to do evil to you. But you do good to evil. That is how to overcome evil with goodness. Then Father God gives blessing to you. Someone has got angry, but the other is at peace. No feeling at all. He hates you, but you say, well, it's okay. I did something wrong before. Please, let's pursue goodness like this. Then you may have, we may not have any difficulties. Even someone brings us difficulties, we don't feel it. And then we may have strength to overcome all the difficulties, and instead we may receive blessings from Father God. So, let us find all these ill feelings and repent of them, and let us receive blessing and love from Father God all the more. May you receive this blessing and enjoy your happiness and joy in your life. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I pray. Let's receive Senior Pastor's prayer for the sick on screen. Lay your hand on your chest for the desires of your heart, or put your hand on your sick body to be healed. Hallelujah, Father God. Please lay your hands on all those who are receiving this prayer now. By transcending space and time, show your works to your children who are receiving this prayer on the internet and through GCN in Brain Churches and local sanctuaries around the world. Give them the faith to believe and drive away all negative thoughts and doubts and drive away all tests and trials. From head to toe, all entrails, joints, nerves, tissues, and cells, whatever the sick part may be, burn them with the fire of the Holy Spirit and with the original light. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command the enemy, devil, and Satan, all diseases, germs, and viruses, and infirmities, go away. May the light come. Scorch all the terminal and incurable diseases with the fire of the Holy Spirit. Drive away all endemic diseases such as malaria. All contagious diseases such as cold, flu, and fever go away. Protect them from all kinds of germs and viruses. Heal them of stomach, lung, liver, breast, uterine, intestinal, and all other cancers. AIDS, leukemia, cerebral apoplexy, high and low blood pressure, diabetes, thyroid, heart, lung, and women's diseases and all inflammations be cleansed and go away. Healed them of polio, stroke, arthritis, and herniated discs. Back pain, headache, neuralgia, and all other pains go away. Epilepsy, autism, depression, neurosis, and other mental diseases go away. All kinds of paralysis be loosened. Get up, walk, and leap. Let the eyes see well. Let the ears hear well. Let the blind come to see, the deaf come to hear, and mute come to speak. Heal them of after effects of all kinds of accidents and fix their broken bones. Let the heat and burning sensation go away. Restore them from burns. Let there be no burning skull left. All kinds of drug addictions, poisoning, and substance abuse go away. Let the dead nerve tissues and cells be regenerated and bring the dead back to life. Give them the blessing of conception. May you receive the blessing of conception. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command the enemy devil and Satan and their ruler of the air go away. And their servants also go away. Go away, you evil, unclean, false, and deceitful spirits, separating spirits and all forces of darkness. Loosen the bonds of wickedness. Darkness, you go away. May the light come. Father God, give them strength to cry out in prayer, to cast off sin, and to become sanctified. As their soul prosper, let all things go well with them, and let their family be evangelized. Protect them from all kinds of accidents and disasters throughout this week, and bless them to lead a prosperous life without any problems. With the firewall of the Holy Spirit, with heavenly hosts and angels, and with your blessing eyes, protect all your children, their family, workplace, and business. Give our students wisdom and understanding, and give them fervent passion to study hard. Keep their hearts and minds from the worldly things, and bless our students to love Father God all the more fervently. Whether your children eat or drink or whatever they may do, let them do it all for the glory of Father God. Let them say, I met God, I received answers. I received answers and blessings. I experienced God. Let them testify like this. Father God, thank you. Be glorified alone. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. それは命与える救いの